So, ladies and gentlemen, Christian Metz is now with me here in our studio. Good to have you here again to have a chat about what happened so far. And yes, we convinced ourselves today about the innovative strength of IST. IST and innovations, this comes good together, right?
I think it's a quite good fit. I think we gave good proof the whole day how innovation IST fits together. I think it was clear, and I think exactly Hida and Fares shows us they're really keen on trying things out to produce innovation from a laboratory to the commercial world. Of course, not all of them will be a commercial, but at least a good idea in the drawer, maybe to be picked out later. And that's why I feel very happy with IST and innovation. I think it's a good fit, definitely.
So how does innovation at IST look like? To innovate innovations.
So we have two principles. I think there's a chaos principle. You know, if you wake up in the night and have a good idea, I think it's allowed to be crazy and funny and to be open to invent things. And the other one is a quite distinct process. We have it's called innovation funnel. So we have a large radar to find out what applications can suit and fit to us. And of course, not all of them are really suitable in terms of making a commercial case out of it. But some of them do. And then we start sometimes a very costly project, and then we're going to execute.
Sounds great. So how do you see this change from UV to LED?
Yeah, I think it was quite clear today that there will be a change. I remember quite well, together with my colleague Holger in the Drupa 2016, next to our booth was an LED-only manufacturer, and they were telling us the lamp era is over. It was quite scary to us, but at least we see that the lamp technology still has a good reason to be present in the market. There will be in future, but of course there will be some changes, and many applications can be answered with LED technology, of course, but there will be some remaining because special solutions require special ideas.
Yes, so. Exactly. Will only LED systems be developed in the future?
That IST does it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. We already do it. And again, I think there will be a mixture, and the mixture is changing a little more from the lamp as a higher portion to the LED, but IST will. So that's my guess, my bet, always being capable to deliver both in a very high quality and high performance manner.
So tell us, what else do you have in store? What exciting developments are currently you're working on at IST?
I don't want to tell you too much, as Tim doesn't want to in the morning. But of course, there's some things I can tell you. We already talked a little about air purification in the morning, and I think it's a good point to continue that topic. Actually, you know, we are producing UV systems in more than 40 years. My grandfather invented it more or less, and it was quite clear that you not only can do like doing application within the printing industry, but also next to it. And so, especially in the pandemic, in the COVID phase, it was quite clear that we need an answer, not only in the pharmaceutical way to solve this problem, but also in a technical way. And maybe some politicians here, so I would wish that they be more open for technical innovations, because we have some that helps us to kill and to erase germs, viruses, fungi in a nanosecond. And this is what we're now producing right now. So our public swimming pool in our town, we have already equipped with COVID-free environment technology. Also what we're going to do with the Trade Fair Center in Stuttgart and also the Expo Pavilion. But I don't want to tell you too much because my colleague Oliver Staatsmann has prepared some nice information about that.
So thank you very much, Christian, for this exciting news.